yeah, so just, mate, it's more adrenaline. I never forget the whole 20 minutes. I tried to do as much as I could in that whole time. And I was lucky enough. Shinji said, yeah, you played well, mate. And I got to play 24 games that year. So something I'll never forget.
Yeah, you're one of the, I think, three players that played every game that year. So, yeah. But also, you know, I think you won Rookie of the Year, which is an awards.
Yeah, the award from players that won in that club. The even players that won it after me, I suppose. Looking at blokes like Tedesco and Rooksy's. It's an honour to win a water that club we had.
Yeah, definitely. Mate, you played all year, your form continued. You played City the year after. Perhaps comment on an article that I was reading, lines of Aaron Woods, probably the best front row coming through. And again, you played, I think, all games that year. I don't think you missed a game. Again, that's a great feat, considering that he spent 12 months on the sideline. Through a hamstring injury, mate. That was probably the year that really made you step up to the mark. Because when Tony Payton retired that year, we lost Bryce Gibbs, who was one of our leading front rowers. Keith Galloway was struggling through injury. We had lost Sam Fafita at the time as well. So basically, it was up to you. 21 years old. Like I said, front rowers don't mature to the 26, 27, and Aaron Woods here is having to step up to the mark. How did you go into that season? Did you see that as a responsibility, or did you just come into the 2012 season going, I'm just gonna play footy and see what happens?
Yeah, look, obviously it's tough. I suppose to lose blokes like Toddy. Grew up wanting to play like him. Obviously, I used to do all the pre-season with him just to pick his brain as much as possible, because as you know, he's a very smart footballer. Halfback in the front row's body. So as I said, picked his brain a lot. He'd always say to me, look, it's going to be a time when obviously we're blessed at the time when I first got there. We had Gibbs, Galloway, Toddy, those junior Moores, Cashmere as well. So I was, as I said, 19, 20, so I was lucky enough to punt it. And then the next year, they were all gone. They all disappeared. So that was tough. But in saying that, we got a bloke, Adam Blair. Obviously, a lot of people didn't really see what he did a lot on the field. He did a lot of stuff behind the scenes. He was one of the most senior players. He did a lot of the 1% plays, which things that you want to sort of pride yourself on, that I sort of try to do as well. But yeah, mate, as I said, going this pre-season.
He came from Melbourne as a player that was going to be, the bustling front row or whatever.
I think he was expecting like 10 tries.
Yeah, 10 tries and whatever else. But he was more a player that, like you said, did the little things. His work ethic was just, second to none. And I think that's where we got our value with Blairy, where you saw him do it, and all our younger kids, and especially your Polynesian kids who probably don't have that work ethic at a young age, came in and saw how hard Blairy worked, and that's what rubbed off on our players, and that's where we got our value. I'm sure Blairy, put his hand up and say he probably didn't have the best season in some of the games, but his training ethic was what counted the most. Mate, 2012 was a big test for you as well. Same as, I think we've had the same situation with Tedesco this year, was it last year? This year, I think it was. Because you're playing so well, like I said, you're leading front rower. Manly came along and decided to offer you a bunch of money. They brought in one of the Ally trucks, I think it was that much. Yeah. Mate, that was a test of your loyalty, and we talk about loyalty in rugby league, and some people say it's dead and it's not there anymore. But mate, alongside yourself, Tedesco, Brooksy, Mitchell Moses, I think that's starting to come back. And for yourself, mate, it was a test because it was well publicised that Manly threw a bit of cash at you to go, but you stayed, mate. So what was the driving factor to stay with the West Tigers?
It was a pretty tough one, I suppose, as well. I was a massive Manly supporter, as I said before. Sorry, Cole.
Keep bringing that up, mate.
I'm not anymore, mate. I think
it's just the rubber stopping you, mate. Sorry.
And, actually, I remember I sat down with Tim Sheens at the time, and he knew what was going on. And he just said, you can chase the money, or you can learn to become a better football player at this club. You got the blokes like, as you said, Skando. Tony Payton was coaching 20s at the time, and Keefe Galloway is the other front rower we had there as well. So, and obviously, if you do chase the money, then comes a lot of responsibility. You got a new club, as I said, with Blairy. Plays one bad game there, but he's on his back straight away. And Mate, for me, the biggest thing was I wanted to learn to play rugby league. I was still only 21. And obviously, I grew up in Leichhardt. I loved the Tigers. And yeah, so to be honest, I never really thought of leaving the club. It was never in my mind. Yeah, I never really thought of going, to be honest with you. As I said, from that.